Abhijit Mukherjee. He's a faculty in the Department of Mathematics in Palna College. So he'll be speaking on discreteness in SL2H using test maps. Okay. Abhijit Mukherjee, you can go.
So I would like to thank the organizers and Dr. Abhijit Pal for nicely introducing me. So, okay. So I'm not going to waste any time. So this talk is based on work with Dr. Krishnendu Gangopadhyay. And my title of my talk is Discreteness in SL2H using test maps. So, okay. So the talk based on this basic problem in the theory of friction groups, the basic problem is discreteness. So which means that given any two elements in PSL2R, whether or not the group generated by them is discrete. And what does it mean by a discrete group? So a discrete group means a topological group which is discrete with respect to the topology defined in the group. Okay. And investigations on Fuchsian groups was initiated by H. Poincaré in 1882 in connection with the discreteness problem, and he called these groups Fuchsian in the name of Fuch. Yeah. Okay. Discrete subgroups of the Möbius groups are actually of considerable interest due to their importance in several branches of mathematics. Okay. Now our work was motivated basically by this result by Troil Jorgensen in the year of 1976. And he stated that, stated an inequality that the generators of a discrete non-elementary two-generator subgroup of SL2C necessarily satisfy. And my primary aim in this talk is to give some ideas to test discreteness of a Jarisky-dense subgroup that I will going to define, which will be determined by two generator discrete subgroups in SL2H, having one isometry from the group and another one we can choose suitably and may not be in the group that we have considered. And this two generator subgroup will influence the discreteness of the whole group in view of certain generalizations of Jorgensen inequality for two generator subgroups in SL2H. That has been formulated, and those results will be used in this work. Okay. And the motivated result in this work was by Jorgensen, and it is the theorem that states that a non-elementary group of PSL2C is discrete if and only if its two generator subgroups are discrete. That means the discreteness of a subgroup in PSL2C is determined by the two generator discreteness of the two generator subgroups. Yeah. Okay. So I'm not going to. Okay. So let me some briefly just describe this space. So I would like to introduce the H2 as a right vector space over the ring of quaternions H, which is a natural example of quaternionic right vector space that can be defined as this with respect to usual addition and scalar multiplication. And let us introduce a relation on the set H2 minus 0 defined as for any two vector ZW. These are equivalent if and only if there exists a non-zero scalar such that W can be expressed as Z lambda. And this equivalence relation partitions the set. And if you consider that this distinct equivalence classes, which has been denoted by P1H, and that P1H will be the H-cap, that is H union, the infinity point, which is homeomorphic to the sphere S4. Okay. And using a standard lift, one can induce the action of SL2H on H-cap by lift multiplication on the standard lift followed by the right projection as the group of quaternionic Möbius transformations, which is evident from the following equation. Yes, it is, that is Az is actually, so it is P of Az, that is Az plus B Cz plus D inverse. And that actually introduces the quaternionic Möbius transformation. So due to the natural correspondence, this A to AZ from SL2H to the group of quaternionic Möbius transformations, we identify the group of quaternionic Möbius transformations with PSL2H. And now let us define the hyperbolic pipe space by this definition. That is, H5 is the set of all those points Z, T in R5 such that the last coordinate is greater than zero. And by Poincaré extensions, one can show that PSL2H actually maps H5 onto itself, and the group SL2H acts as an orientation preserving isometric group of the hyperbolic pipe space H5. And note that, as we have already stated, that H cap is the conformal boundary S4 of the hyperbolic pipe space. Now the action by the group SL2H that acts on H cap is extended over H5 by Poincaré extension. And the process of construction is more likely, as in the case of hyperbolic tree space, by PSL2C. Yes. So the orientation preserving isometric group of this space is PSL2H. Now we can classify the isometry by their fixed points as elliptic, parabolic, and hyperbolic or loxodromic in a similar fashion as that of PSL2C. And this classification can be characterized algebraically by conjugacy invariance of the isometries. Now, note that every element in SL2H is conjugate to an upper triangular matrix. And for that reason, Professor Gangobadhyay has classified these classes. The complete characterization of conjugacy classes in GL2H, and that can be represented like this. So we may classify those members in usual manner, which has been defined in the next slide. Okay, sure. So an elliptic or hyperbolic element is conjugate to a matrix of the form lambda 0, 0, mu, where lambda, mu are in complex number. And if mod lambda equal to mod mu is 1, then A is elliptic. And otherwise, it is hyperbolic or loxodromic. A hyperbolic element will be called strictly hyperbolic if it is conjugate to a real diagonal matrix, non-identity of course. Yes. A parabolic isometry is conjugate to an element of this form, lambda 1, 0, lambda, where mod lambda is 1. So our goal that we have achieved to test discreteness of a subgroup G by considering two generator subgroups by means of suitable test maps, which are to be suitably chosen and that need not be in the subgroup G. By the use of Jorgensen type inequalities for a two generator subgroup FG generated by FG in the group SL2H, and the inequalities that we have obtained in our first work. So the line of investigation has been initially motivated by the remarkable result of Jorgensen and Kikka that I have stated earlier. And aftermath in higher dimensions, Abikoff and Hash, they proved a Jariskidian subgroup G of Möbius transformation group MN is discrete if and only if every two generator subgroup is discrete in G. And along this line, Min Chen's work that motivated us, since he proved a Jariskidian subgroup G of MN is discrete if the group FG is discrete where G is in the group and F is a fixed non-trivial element of MN, maybe chosen outside the group G, which is not an irrational rotation that is of infinite order. Or if having finite order, that doesn't pointwise fix the boundary. Now I need to define two objects that, so let us suppose that A belongs to SL2H and let us consider this form, that is A is lambda 0, 0, mu. Then we can define argument trace of A to be argument lambda plus argument mu and absolute trace of A as mod lambda plus mod mu. Okay. Now, so the definition of Jariskidian subgroups are like that. A subgroup is said to be Jariskidian if it doesn't have a global fixed point or neither it preserves a proper totally geodesic subspace of H5. So these are our main theorems. So in our study, you choose a test maps not necessarily belong to the concerned group that we have considered in SL2H. That is, let G be a Jarisky-Den subgroup of SL2H. So F be a two rotatory elliptic element, not necessarily an element of G. Satisfying this condition, that is 0 less than argument trace F less than pi by 3. Then for every, if for every hyperbolic element G in G, if the two generator subgroup FG is discrete, then capital G is discrete. Okay. Now the second result is like that. If we consider F to be a hyperbolic element, and again, if it is not necessarily in the group G, and satisfying this condition that half of absolute trace square F minus 3 is less than cos of argument trace F, and if for every hyperbolic element G in G, capital G, if the two generator subgroup FG is discrete, then the whole group capital G is discrete. And the third statement is for the parabolic element. That is, if you consider F to be a parabolic element in SL2H, not necessarily in the group G. And suppose you take the parabolic element as 1, mu, 0, 1, where mod mu is less than 1 up to conjugacy. So for every hyperbolic element G in capital G, if the two generator subgroup is discrete, then G is discrete. So these are the results that we have obtained. Okay, so I'm not going to few lines I want to give. Okay, so actually the scheme of the proof depends on the choice of H that is this H. Yes, so that depends on the hyperbolic the choice of the hyperbolic element which will exist in the group G if it is not discrete, and that Z0, that fixed point, is not equal to 0 infinity. So that, so this existence will ensure the choice of this H for the first and second case. And for the last one, that is for the parabolic case, you need to choose this element as like that. That is 1, 0 minus Z0 inverse 1. And then, since G is not discrete, then you can have that that using the denseness of G, you can get distinct sequences Hn and Gn, Hn for the first and second case, and Gn for the last one, satisfying these properties. And then you will have this equation, that is Hg, H inverse, and that will be like this. Yes. And this matrix will give you the conclusion. That is, since Z0 is a fixed point of G, then that part is 0. Okay. So using the inequality that we have obtained in our first work, then this inequality will leads to a contradiction to the inequality for any non-elementary discrete subgroups that will satisfy. Yes. Yeah. And this theorem says that one may choose certain irrational rotations as test maps, which is a very interesting part of our investigation. And if you go through minutely, then you may observe that you have chosen actually one parameter family of test maps to test desired discreteness of the whole group G. Okay. And then after having this result, you can also have another one that is that looks like the same, but here we are taking one generator to be a test map F and the other is a conjugate of F by a hyperbolic element of G. And the complete statement is like that here. Yeah. Just we are taking the this one, that is F, G, F, G inverse. So these two generator subgroups we are considering. Yeah. Okay. So I would like to make two, three remarks on that. So to prove the above two theorems, we have used Jorgensen type inequalities for two generator subgroups of SL2H, which we have obtained. And the second remark is that it is necessary to impose suitable restriction to the quantities, argument tracer and absolute tracer, in the above two theorems. And interestingly, these quantities emerged out from the Jorgensen type inequalities that we have obtained in our first work, and this restriction cannot be relaxed. Yes. And the third remark is that if we observe case one of the above two theorems, we see that the quantity argument trace F cannot be zero, because in that case F will be reduced to an one literary elliptic. And the fourth remark is that if you look at the case in which argument trace F is pi by 3, then we find at once that the arguments we give here become inconclusive. And the last one is that in case 2, if the inequality will become equal, then we must have F is an elliptic transformation of order at least 7. But this leads to a definite contradiction to the hypothesis of choosing F hyperbolic. Okay. So these are the references. Thank you.
Okay, so thank you, Dr. Abhishek, for a nice talk.